Welcome to the Fit Small Business QuickBooks Online Training Course. In this lesson, we're going to cover how to set up your company information. To follow along with me, log into your QuickBooks Online account now, or click the link below this video for a free 30-day trial of QuickBooks Online. You can also find a link below this video to our full QuickBooks Online course and other helpful resources. Let's get started. It's important to complete company information because what you provide in this section will affect the contact information that appears on invoices, sales receipts, and estimates that you send to your customers. Before we begin setting up QuickBooks, you will need to have some basic company information handy, like your business name, your business address, your business email address, your website address, and your tax ID or social security number. While it does make the setup process go much faster if you have this information handy, it's not the end of the world if you have to come back and complete some of the info later. The most important thing to remember is that you need to input this information in its entirety prior to entering any transactions into QuickBooks. After you sign into your QuickBooks Online account, click on the gear icon located to the left of your company name. Go ahead and select Account and Settings directly below your company. In this section, we've got a total of 6 tabs. The first tab is Company Information. To get started, just click the pencil to edit this information. The first thing that we want to do is upload your company logo. Upload the logo that you want to appear on invoices, sales receipts, estimates, and purchase orders. If you don't have a logo, we have included a link below this video to our recommended logo designer. You can always come back in here and upload a logo at any time. As you can see, we have uploaded the logo for a fictitious company, Paul's Plumbing. Company name. We want to enter the company name in this field. If your company name and legal name are the same, this section should take just a second. If you have a different company name and legal name, be sure to note the distinction. Employer ID. If you have an employer identification number, also known as a federal tax ID number, you should enter it in this section. This will be a 9-digit number that is issued by the IRS. However, if you have not applied for a tax ID, then the business owner's social security number is also acceptable. This information is used in preparing your QuickBooks data for tax filing forms and other documents. Let's go ahead and save our changes. The next section is contact information. The information in contact info is used on invoices, sales receipts, and estimates that go out to customers. Company email. The customer email address can be used to correspond with anyone, including vendors, customers, and contractors. I strongly recommend that you set up a separate customer-facing email address so that when your customers contact you about billing issues or general questions, their emails do not get lost in your inbox. We have included a link below this video to our article on how to get a free business email address. Company telephone number. This is the phone number that your customers will use to contact you. If you have a website, you should enter that information in this field. If you don't have a website, you can leave this field blank for now and come back and update it when you do have it up and running. If you don't have a website yet, we've included a link below this video to our article which gives you step-by-step instructions on creating a website. Let's go ahead and save our changes here. And the last section is address. Similar to what we discussed for email address, it is a good idea to have a separate customer-facing physical address. A couple of reasons why you might want to consider this are, if you have a home-based business and you do not wish to share your home address with customers, or if you have had some issues with mail tampering, then you might want bank statements, customer payments, and other important documents to be mailed to a P.O. box, which tends to be more secure. If you have a legal address that is different from your company address and your customer-facing address, then you want to make sure that you enter that information in this field here. Let's go ahead and save our changes. And that wraps up the lesson on how to set up company information in QuickBooks Online. To access our full QuickBooks Online course or any of the other lessons in this series, click the link below this video. You can also find a link below this video for a free 30-day trial of QuickBooks Online.